a pop star, an international pop star in her own right. I speak, of course, of Kim Wilde. Hey, Kim.
Hello.
Looking $1 million too, I must say.
Yes! Oh, thank you.
Now, that is that the black dress that you were telling me about in the dressing room when you were late for that concert?
What, this one, you
this
mean?
This particular black dress.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yes, it is, actually.
Just to say what happened, you were wearing this skimpy black dress, this particular skimpy black dress.
And, no, I was, in Europe with David Bowie doing some tours.
Yes.
Bit of a name dropper.
Yes.
Can't help that.
The David Bowie?
Yeah, the, you know.
Big Dave, as I know him.
Exactly, your close friend.
Yes.
And I had to get back to London to do National Radio 1 live radio. Live radio, like this is live, which
this is... Except this is television.
I'm getting so sort of fizzy inside. And anyway, so...
Glenn's getting all excited.
And then, anyway, so we flew back quickly to Heathrow, and then I had a flight to Plymouth, and then we had to drive down to Torquay, and I was within 10 minutes of getting to this live show, which I was just about to miss, and like I'd been up since 5 and flown all the way over, and I was going to miss it, and I was in this traffic jam. I said, what am I going to do? I thought, well, the only way I'm going to get there is on a bike. So we got out the car, waved down a motorbike guy who I don't know who he was, and his friend, and got his friend off. I said, yoo-hoo!
Standing there in the little outfit.
With this little top on here. Could you possibly take me to my show? So I'm going to miss it. And he did. And there I was on the back of a motorbike with like this little dress on. And come on, get on, get a move on.
Did he actually take you to the concert or did he take you somewhere else?
Well, yeah. No, he actually got me there just in time. And he was a real hero for the day, you know. But it was a
bizarre... Oh, isn't that fantastic?
Yeah. And he was such a sweet guy, you know. One of the nicest guys I've met.
And in fact, of course, you are now engaged to him. And now, you've got a new clip out, a new song. The song is called, just bear with me here, the song is called Can't Get Enough of Your Love. You know what it's called? Can't Get Enough of Your Love. Let's have a look at this new clip, the new song, the new video, the new work from Kim Wilde, Can't Get Enough of Your Love. Okay. Kim Wilde can't get enough of your love.
Just asking you what I did, Steve. I said I ride motorbikes for a living and stuff.
You'll be riding around for hours trying to pick someone up later. Yeah. Now, you've worked with Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
You did what in respect of Michael Jackson? You were the lead act?
Well, he closed the show for me, actually. Well, he closed about 32 shows for me.
It was a fantastic experience, though, to work with Michael.
Yeah, it was wonderful.
Big Mickey, as I've come to name him.
No, it was a wonderful opportunity. I couldn't really believe that I got offered the gig. I mean, this was about 2 years ago. And we started off, we were going to do 20, and then we ended up doing 30. It was brilliant.
Was this a Thriller tour?
Well, what was it? No, it was
Because that's
bad
the only
tour.
Michael Jackson song I know.
No, Bad.
The Bad Tour.
Yeah, the Bad Tour. It's great.
And did you have to, how'd you get on with Michael?
Well, actually, we only met once during the whole time.
You worked with him?
Yeah, he was just so crazy about me, you know.
Yeah, obviously caring, sharing sort of guy. Did, once, what happened?
Once,
what happened there once? It obviously got a house on fire that time.
Yeah, it was 2 weeks into the tour, and I went to meet him, and it was really a publicity thing. We had a photo taken, and there was quite a lot of bad publicity, because people kept saying, have you met him yet? What's he like? And I kept having to say, well, no, I haven't met him. And then he was getting bad press, and...
Because he hadn't met you?
Because he hadn't met me, and then they're saying, you know, Kim Wilde snubbed by Michael Jackson, and I really didn't mind too much because I kind of accepted that Michael Jackson is Michael Jackson. He's where he is. Mm-hmm. It's not what I understand, but I can respect the guy. You know, you have to respect someone's wishes.
Yeah, that bastard, that bastard Michael Jackson. Yeah. What do you think of Michael?
Oh, well, you know, I'm a
you can
big
say
fan.
Personally.
No, I really liked him very
wonderful
much.
Guy, that three words that he said.
What can I say? I met him for 2 minutes. I mean,
what did he
say
to you? Out of my way, bitch.
No, he didn't.
Aussie. What did he say?
Well, he just sort of, you know, he was very sweet and nice, but he was very softly spoken, and he seemed terribly shy. I mean, I thought I was shy till I met him. I mean,
what about David Bowie?
Well, he's totally different now. He's in the dressing room every night. How you doing?
Are you a big Bowie fan?
Well, I am now.
Have you met his ex-wife, Angie Bowie?
No, we haven't met, no. Mm. She seems like an extraordinarily interesting girl.
Yeah, she's a lovely lady.
Yeah.
I had a lovely chat with Angie. What's it like meeting all these big stars? I mean, you're a megastar yourself.
The worst thing about meeting David Bowie, for me, is that I was very starstruck. Which was very embarrassing. Being starstruck is awful.
Yeah, so what did you say to him?
Well, not a lot, because I was so starstruck. And every time I used to walk in the dressing room and say, "Hi, Kim, have a great show tonight, and how's your dad, and what's going on?" Hi.
And that was it.
And that was it, really,
that was it. Kim, will you stick around? We're going to take a break. Will you stay back for the rest of your time? Kim, we're going to take a break. We'll be back with more after this. This is... Incidentally, I should have thanked a few people. I should thank them, and I will thank them in the following order. British Airways, the world's favourite airline. Fantastic. They flew us over here. They flew us in a plane. They flew us when we landed and everything. OTC, toll-free fax number. Thank you very much. Ted's Camera Store for the JVC video cam. And I've got to say thank you to the London Weekend Television crew, because they... They've done something that we don't see a lot of in Australian television. They remain sober, which is a start. Sober-ish. How you going, Peter? Peter O'Connor, the world's most Catholic floor manager.
Damn fine.
Are you still half-tanked?
Are
you still half-tanked? Look at him, will you? Have you done much shopping, Pete?
Shop till I dropped. No, actually, I didn't. No.
What have you bought?
That's a new shirt, I think.
It's a new shirt, though, Pete.
No, I bought a few things. Tony Vilt's saying, show the shirt. I bought a shirt.
Look at him. This is our floor manager, and he's as pissed as a newt. He's standing. I bought a shirt. Unbelievable.
It's a 10-pin bowling shirt, isn't it, Peter?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, it is.
Now, Kim, your new... Kim. The new LP, the new album...
Good.
Briefly tell us about that.
Well, it's called Love Moves, and it's been out for a few months, and Can't Get Enough. It's like one of the second singles, I think, on it. Although the singles have changed all over the place. There's different ones out in France, and it's doing okay.
It's doing okay, and I bet it's going to do great guns in Australia. I've just got a hunch about that. It'll do great guns, and because...
It will now,
It will now. It's going to go... Our next guest tonight...